can I begin by asking you, how well do you think the Russian economy has done through this COVID period? And how concerned are you that the economy appears to be losing momentum?
Of course, COVID-19 pandemic has affected Russian economy significantly, and an economic decline in the second quarter was about -8%. It was less than we feared. And maybe the number is somewhat smaller than in other countries, advancing countries. It's due first to the structure of Russian economy, with a smaller share of sectors more affected by the pandemic. I mean, services sector, tourism, and small and medium enterprises in general. And The second reason why this effect was smaller than many feared, it's a well-targeted government program to support household incomes, business, and it helped to sustain demand. But the situation is different in export. You know, our Russian economy depends on energy export, and we see that due to pandemic, the global demand has declined significantly. The first reason is less travel and mobility in general reduced a lot. And we see now that export will recover at a slower pace. The third quarter was quite good for the Russian economy, and the economic recovery was very dynamic, and it was led by the sector of national goods, domestic goods consumption, as in many other countries. And however, the autumn COVID-19 escalation, it led to some slowdown in the recovery. And that's why we revised our forecast for this year only to plus half a percentage point, and we expect this year the economy will contract by between 4 and 5 percent. And we brought down our forecast for the next year, and we think that the growth will be between 3 and 4%, and it will led by the internal consumption. And it's due to lesser drop in 2020 than we anticipated, and but also for a more gradual recovery in the last quarter this year and the first quarter next year.
If you are forecasting a lower growth rate going forward, and fresh lockdowns affect and lower inflation expectations, does that mean, even though you've held rates in the last two meetings, that there is room for you to do more coming into the December meeting and then maybe early into next year?
Yes, we made a pause in our rate reduction in September, in October. But before that, if we consider the dynamic of key rate from June last year, we cut in total 350 basis points. And we see some room for further reduction. It's limited. It's not so large as it was before, but we will decide how and when to use this room according to incoming data. And we made a pause in September and October assessing the short-term pro-inflationary risks and some risks related to financial stability in the markets. And that's why we think we should be more, careful about the development of the situation with pandemic, with geopolitical issues and other issues.
Well, does that mean then that you still consider the bias in rates to be to the downside, even though you're being cautious?
Yes, of course we think, because the COVID-19 escalation in autumn, it increases the disinflationary risk, the risk for demand, and we see that in a medium-term perspective, disinflationary risk will prevail, of course. And we think that our policy will remain accommodative through the end of next year. And we think that the effect of decisions of cutting rates that we've made before, it will last through the end of this year at least.
One of the challenges, of course, has been the consequences of the volatility in the ruble. Do you expect that volatility also to continue?
Of course, when we decide on our key rate, we assess the situation in the foreign currency markets. Yes, the volatility of ruble this year has been increased, but it is somewhat in the range of volatility, for example, in 2018. And we have less pass-through to the inflation. And of course, we see that the global economic development is quite uncertain in many aspects. First of all, related to pandemic development, and it can cause some volatility in global markets, in the Russian market. We take into account this, as usual. But it's difficult to predict what will be with volatility of currency markets.
Yes, I mean, one of the challenges, obviously, has been the decline in household disposable income, and obviously real wage growth has stalled at this point. To what extent do you feel that the government needs to be doing more at this point at a fiscal level to provide support for the average Russian?
As I said, the government has already provided a fiscal support, a very targeted fiscal support to households and to businesses, primarily to small and medium enterprises. And as I know, the government assess now the sufficiency of these measures, taking into account the development with the pandemic. As for example, the Russian Central Bank, we provide monetary easing, but also we've taken some measures on regulatory side. And we provided regulatory forbearance for our banks to continue credit expansion, to restructure credits for households, for small and medium businesses. And we constantly monitor how these measures work and if they are sufficient. And we will take decisions according to the development of pandemic and the economic situation.
Governor, you talked about geopolitical risks. A lot of analysts think that if Joe Biden, the Democrat, wins the US election, that could mean fresh sanctions for Russia. Can I ask you, are you at the central bank at the moment modeling potential outcomes for both Biden and Trump? And ultimately, what would it mean if there were fresh sanctions as a result of the Democrats winning?
We have been Russia has been living under sanctions for some years already, and under threat of new fresh sanctions, and we take into account this possibility, this scenario, of course. That's why our policy not to to predict when these sanctions or if these sanctions can occur, but to prepare our economy, our financial system sector to withstand new geopolitical risks. That's why we keep, for example, our buffers. Our buffers may be at the level higher than other countries and higher than, for example, international standards recommend. These buffers, they can help in the situation like this with pandemic. And for example, banks can use the accumulated buffers, and the government can use the buffers, fiscal buffers, to provide fiscal stimulus. But it can be used in the situation if some geopolitical risk materialize.
Governor, thank you so much. Bolshoye spasiba. Good to see you once again.